fully explain how prayer works. But I know this much for sure. In an emergency, when someone calls 911, it's a most urgent cry for help. In many ways, it's a prayer. And how does that cry for help get answered? It gets answered by the members of the FDNY and the NYPD.
I would like to introduce you to my husband, Paul, a 19-year veteran of the NYPD and a sergeant that worked midnight tours, who was responsible for the domestic violence unit of the 43rd Precinct. He was a quiet leader. He was funny and sarcastic. But above anything else, the two most important people in Paul's life were our children, Austin and Joseph. The boys were just 4 and 3 years old when Paul was killed. That night I cried as I knelt over Paul as he was covered in a flag, all because he was protecting a woman and her 3-year-old child who was being held at gunpoint against her will by a gang member. I will say that there's a lot that I don't remember after losing Paul. But I will say that one of the moments that I still remember was when Answer the Call came to my home and presented me with a generous check to help ease the burden of a portion of the funeral costs and other expenses I now had to bear on my own. The care and comfort that was provided to me that day was just a little glimpse in the astonishing ways that Answer the Call has been there for my family.
They protect us, they take care of us, so we have to support them, especially in their greatest time of need, because this is a community.
It's our 37th annual gala, started by my friend Rusty Staub. You can see the energy in this room, the kind of commitment that we have to our first responders in New York City. I am so proud of what we've been able to do to make a difference in the lives of widows and children whose loved ones died in the line of duty.
Regardless of how they spell their names or their race, religion, color, and creed, these are the greatest people in the world. They put their lives on the line every day for us. Without them, we couldn't survive.
Thanks to all of you, and thanks to an extremely generous honoree, Todd Morley, tonight we were able to raise $4 million for the families of our fallen heroes. Thank you.
This dinner is incredible. Hearing the stories of the families never fails to inspire. Let's raise some money and make sure these families are well taken care of.
Stuart, you ready to go to 25? Come on, park it up, Steve. 25,000. You willing to go to 25? 25. Guess what? I got two of these. 25 on the right, 25 on the left. 50,000 bucks. Done.
Woo! Have the current administration come, just add to the level of support. It means a lot to us. And most importantly, it means a lot to the widows and the families.
You can't say it enough. We love you, people, for what you do, the sacrifice you make, and everyone in this room supports and loves you too.
On behalf of my family and all of the many others that you have helped, thank you for answering the call.